ready.
We're hitting that depressing stage because, well, at least I am, because this is our last full day.
We're not talking about it.
It only feels like yesterday we arrived. It's felt really long, but it's also felt really quick. If that makes any sense.
So we're off to breakfast just at the resort because it's handy.
Well, I'm going to put my mobile order through now.
Yeah, so we just do it on the mobile order and then pick it up when we're there.
The tip is, if you're staying at this resort and you're on this side, say I'm here, prepare my order now, and then by the time you get there, it'll be ready for you. Because if you hit it when you're there, you just have to stand there and wait.
Yeah. So we're off to breakfast at the resort, and then we will let you know what we're up to the rest of the day. We didn't even show breakfast, did we?
I don't think we did, no.
Sorry guys, I just had Nicky walk on the guest standard protocol on holiday.
Yeah, it's probably the last one. We might get it tomorrow again before we go.
But. So we've just arrived in United Kingdom.
Again, sorry, the last vlog we're also here.
I know. But you know, we've got to squeeze in every last
one. That's kind of happened this week. We kind of ended up in like the same place 2 days in a row for different reasons.
But yeah, so we're going to try and do the last of what we haven't done.
Yeah, plus this is our last full day, so you have to do your last full day at Magic Kingdom.
You have to, it's what you do.
Try to do the Carousel Of Progress today.
Oh yeah.
We'll try and do the boat, try and do the island.
Yeah, and we might nip over to the Grand Floridian.
Just to show it, because it's amazing.
Just to show it, yeah.
I mean, we've got our resort cups with us today.
So you can
fill your cup at any resort. So, you know, free drinks. Just as we walked in, Dapper Dan is singing on the back of the horse. We go to Magic Kingdom, we always tend to drift this side first. I feel like most people go left and go to Adventureland. Maybe they don't. This bit's so cool. It's that whole old school version of the future that I love.
How would you describe Carousel Of Progress?
So it goes through like how technology has changed.
Right,
so it starts in like the 1900s and then keeps going through. It's quite cool.
And there's the best song, that song.
Yeah, and this was at the World Fair, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It's like the 50s or 60s World Fair, and it hasn't changed. So the technology you're seeing here, the technology they were using for rides like 50 years ago.
Carousel Of Progress. You're in for a real treat. The Carousel Of Progress was Walt's own idea from beginning to end. He loved it. He introduced the show at the World's Fair in New York City in 1964, and it was an immediate smash hit. Millions of people came to see it. And since then, the Carousel Of Progress has had more performances than any other stage show in the history of American theater. He thought it would be fun to watch the American family go through the 20th century, experiencing all the new wonders as they came. And he put them together in a show called Carousel Of Progress, which we are now about to see. Although our carousel family has experienced a few changes over the years, our show still revolves around the same theme, and that's progress.
Great, big, beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great, big, beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow is just a dream away.
I'm a farm, and when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great,
looks like the robins are getting ready to celebrate Valentine's Day today. What year is it? Oh, right around the turn of the century. And believe me, things couldn't be any better than they are today. Yes, sir, buildings are towering now as high as 20 stories. And moving pictures flicker up on a big screen. We have almost 8,000 automobiles in this country, and we can travel by train from New York to California in less than 7 days. And I even hear tell about two brothers from North Carolina who are working on some kind of flying contraption. It'll never work.
A great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow is just a dream away. Man has a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream with mind and heart. And when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true.
The July we've had in years. We've come a long way though since the turn of the century, over 20 some odd years ago. You know that pilot fella, Charles Lindbergh? He's about to fly a single wing airplane all the way across the Atlantic. He's never gonna make it. There goes Schwartz in his Huffmobile. He sure loves that horn. You know, in my new Essex, I've got an electric starter. Now I don't have to crank. We can travel from New York to Los Angeles by train in only 3 days. And we've got a house full of new electrical servants. Mr. Edison sure added life to our home.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow's just a dream away. It's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day.
It's another Halloween here in the fabulous 40s. Everything is better than ever now, and we've got some amazing new wonders around the house to prove it. For instance, our refrigerator holds more food and ice cubes. And thanks to our automatic dishwasher, I don't have to dry the dishes anymore after supper. Gives Rover and me more time to enjoy our evening stroll together. Everybody.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow's just a dream away.
Isn't it a pleasant holiday? Oh, turkey's in the oven, it's peaceful and quiet.
Yes! 300 points, my best score yet.
Well, it was peaceful until Santa brought that new virtual reality space pilot game.
Your turn, Grandma. Let's switch the image over to the TV so the resident flying ace can show you how it works.
Hey, everybody. I'm done programming our new voice activation system.
Now all our household items will do anything we tell them to do.
Great. Tell the refrigerator to bring me a root beer.
Well, it can't quite do that, but I'll show you something it can do. Tree lights 30% brighter.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow is just a dream away.
That's a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream with mind and heart. And when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true for you and me.
So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow.
Thank you for joining us on Walt Disney's Carousel of Progress. We hope you've enjoyed this tribute to the 1964 Carousel of Progress from the New York World's Fair.
Oh, where are we?
Hi.
So it's down the... Oh, where are you going?
What's
the carousel.
So cute.
It's funny. It's funny to think that hasn't changed. It was 1960 World Fair. I went a bit too early. It's mad to think that hasn't changed since then.
It's just a nice ride to... Not a ride, but like a show to sit in, have a little bit of aircon and...
Yeah, that's good.
And the song's so catchy.
Yeah, I'm still blown away that that was made like 50 years ago.
Yeah, it's
like at the time, that must have blown people's minds.
Yeah.
But I love, but the predictions they made for the future kind of are true.
Yeah.
Like we have Alexa and Siri and all these things, automation is mad. We are currently cutting through the main hub of the park to go to Adventureland, to go to the Swiss Family Robinson Treehouse, isn't it? So what is this like? You just sort of walk around the big treehouse they built in the story and see how they lived and all. It's quite cool. Also, not many people actually bother to do this.
Yeah.
It's actually just a walk around a big pretend tree, but I don't know, I like it.
Pretend?
Yeah, it's not a real tree. You'd think it. It really does look real, doesn't it? Is this when they washed up the shore? Driving the treehouse, is what you just said. It's mad to think that's all fake, isn't it? Like, that's all fake. Look how real that looks. Oh, you can see Space Mountain. You can see Tron as well. Castle through the trees. It's very cool. So you can actually see Jungle Cruise here and then parts of the Caribbean all the way at the end there. The Crow's Nest, this is called. I think this is the first time we've done this during the day.
Yeah, Tuesday night.
We used to do this on like the really late night openings. We used to do this, didn't we? Like no one would be on it. Oh, they've got a big shell as a sink over there, you see that? And like plumbing, bamboo plumbing. Yeah, I mean, this is, you said you live in the treehouse and this is where you said you live. You'd be like, oh, okay, that's pretty good. Now we're off to get a dole whip of some description. Oh yeah, one of these dole whips. One of those exact things. That's cool. We're just eating it right here at the sign because it is dripping everywhere. What's it like? Really good?
So refreshing.
Mm. So nice, aren't they? It's like, well, there was like pop rocks on the front. And what's the drink? Some sort of Fanta. It'd be nice when it gets mixed in a bit more. The problem with being in Florida is the second you lift it, it starts melting down the sides.
It was already melting down the girls' hands.
Yeah.
We made it.
Like, we wanted to try and find a seat, but by the time we find a seat, it's all out. I mean, look how much it's melted just sitting here. How would you describe a dole whip? A dole, it's like ice cream, but not quite ice cream.
It's not, it's like fruity, cold. It's not even slushy.
It's like somewhere between sorbet and ice cream, isn't it?
It's so good.
But it's like creamy. It's sort of.
I feel you just can't get it anywhere but here.
Yeah, I think you can only get it here. It's like pineapple ice cream, isn't it? But it's like don't know. It's just so good. You just have to try it. There's nothing like it.
Me, I'm not even an ice cream fan, but I love this.
So we were just looking for a bin there to bin some of the bits and pieces we had. And maybe remember this random fact.
Is it 12 steps?
Yeah.
When you're in a Disney World park, you know more than... I think it was 12 steps away from a bin. So it keeps later down. So there's a bin there. There's a bin there. And there's a bin there. Just from where I'm standing. It doesn't matter where you are in Disney World parks, there's always a bin very, very close to you.
Okay, all done with the Dole Whip. Are you successfully cooled down?
Yes, it's such a good way to cool down.
Yeah, isn't it? So now we're gonna see about maybe doing the Enchanted Tiki Room.
And I'm warning you, this might give you nightmares.
It's incredible. It's basically, if you saw a Halloween, Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party, which is where one of the treat stops was. And it's just a room filled with animatronic birds that sing.
Yep.
So you either love it or it'll be the absolute stuff of nightmares.
Yeah.
It's in that big thatched building just here. Now it's gonna spin on someone. There we go, see? All these people didn't even notice. Let's keep an eye on them. Oh, heads up, Nick. Stop. Stop, stop, stop. There we go. Just keep an eye on the when you're walking past this guy, you need to keep an eye on the wet bits on the floor. So there's three people standing outside Tiki Room, or cast members, and it says 0 minutes until the next show, so it must currently not be working. Or the birds are on strike or something. Poor working conditions, making them sing and dance all day.
But that's the waiting area for it at least. We'll try again later.
Captain Jack is out meeting people. So the next thing we're going to do is get on one of these little boats and go over to Tom Sawyers Island. So there's one docking in. And you just get on this little station. And that's just a little map of it. It's not super big, but there's just like little caves and like a little like wooden fort and stuff, isn't there?
Yeah.
I can't remember what's there. I'm sorry, man. Why do we have to think I have to do that hick voice? That's what we'll be doing later on today.
Just on the little tiny boat to the island.
The Tom Sawyers Island.
Wee!
Have a little
break! That's where we just came from. Well, some of it's the same. So, I mean, literally on the boat for about a minute.
Got to see Big Thunder.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's okay, it's still cool. Let's go this way.
I thought you could see Hawk Mansion from here.
Haunted Mansion. Somewhere of Oh, you're going to the exit. Oh,
you're bad.
I see Big Thunder going by, but I suppose we'll show that when we're on the big boat.
Chickens in there. There's little chickens. There's a horse as well.
I had my sunglasses on, so couldn't actually see.
There's a guardhouse here too. Anyone guarding anything? There's There's a guy sleeping in the guardhouse. Can we go up here? Ooh. Oh no, there's guns here.
Escape tunnel.
But we need to take my sunglasses off for this one.
Yeah.
Oh, it's narrow through here. Oh, I physically climbed through. Okay, back this way I go. Huh? Oh no, it is that way. Couldn't get through. Is that a bag at all? Oh,
sure.
Daylight. Oh my god, so I'd have to duck through here. Oh my god.
It's so narrow. Because I've got a bag on.
I hear the boat. Oh, this doesn't come out where I thought it did. Hello.
Back into the burning.
So this isn't the same bit then? Barrel bridge entrance and then the other way. Holy crap! Wait a second, honey. Oh. Oh, that's not fair. I have to hold the camera.
Yeah, I probably should.
Why am I so unsteady? No, it's no Calgary rope bridge.
Ugh. Remember the story they always paint the fence?
Yeah.
Oh, that was where we go. Hickory Switch Hill.
Go to the hill.
Yeah. I haven't done the cave yet either. So much to see.
All scratches mystery mine.
Yeah, let's go. It's a really scary cave. Ooh.
Ooh. So nice.
Yeah, it's a lot cooler actually. Ooh, there's aircon. I feel the breeze.
Mine.
Oh, was it that? Wow, that really like flows through the tunnel. That is nice in here though.
Whoa,
it's so
there's no way out.
No way out. Oh god, I die down here. The whole thing's sloped.
Whoa. Oh,
this is
that room I tell you about in the escape room thing.
Yeah.
It's like this bit on
the it's weird when the room sloped over. It's supposed to go fall. Oh, there's precious minerals here that no one's taken. Seven dwarfs didn't get. Oh, where did she go? The seven dwarfs they didn't get this far. Dig, 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 dig the hole no through. If that's the right lyric. Well, there's two ways to go.
A trap door, look.
Hmm. Oh, is that a door?
Must be for castle.
Oh.
Me to find that. I think I'm in the escape room.
Oh, my God. Oh,
we've
made it.
Oh, can I just stay here in the cold
air? Oh. No, into the sun. No. No. Take me back into the dark cave. smell nice. We're getting double air right now.
It's like the birds can't in the room.
Thank you.
We're doing the Country Bear Jamboree, which is going to be strange.
Oh. So I was deciding what we were about to do, Country Bear Jamboree. What would you say about this show? Very strange. It's about a thing we knew nothing about as well.
So if you watch some of the rest of our series, you might remember this building from Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party.
Give me a little intro. My parents will play now in a good old key of G. Seeking Sam for 10, friend by our name, Tennessee.
Interesting, wasn't it?
We made it on the boat. Oh, there's only one set of stairs because you load from the middle, don't you?
Suffering with the heat today, aren't we?
Mostly me.
The sun's not even in. Well, the sun's not even out. It's just like, really warm.
head it off the boat. Now we're running to Memento Mori, the gift shop for Water Mansion, because the heat on that boat was disgusting.
Yeah, because it's barely moving.
Yeah. I'm just about to see her there.
I'm right here.
And it's just busy. Okay, so we're looking for somewhere for food. And you've always said this, but I agree. Magic Kingdom has really bad sit-in food options for quick service.
Yeah.
So we checked Cosmic Rays and it's all just burgers and fries. Yeah. And we checked Pinocchio's Village House. And it has great seating, but it's all pizzas and stuff. Lambert Arbor House is fine, but we've been there.
Yeah.
We're actually going to Pecos Bills again, which we were at Halloween Horror Nights. And Mickey's Not Just Scary Halloween Party.
Yeah.
So we were getting a rice bowl this time.
So we'll try it. I've always said when I do my lists for food, Magic Kingdom is the smallest list of places for food to try that is on my list.
Yeah.
And considering it's such a big part,
it's all very crazy. Yeah. The places that are like hatches and windows have cool options, but we really want to just get inside into the aircon for a while. Yeah.
There's strange dancing and singing bears are on the roof. Them crazy bears. There he is. Hello, strange bear.
Okay guys, so we got a chicken rice bean salad, or rice bowl to share. It comes with some salad, guacamole, well you had to pay extra for that, and then just got a cup and some water.
Oh, it was $21 I think.
$21 in total.
No it wasn't.
$19. So we had our little rice bowl and we both said it was very, very good.
Yeah, the food is good. It's always good. It's the only quick service place in Magic Kingdom that's actually decent, apart from Columbia Hot House, which is also very good.
Yeah. And it was more than enough to share, wasn't it?
Oh yeah,
it was a really big portion. And yeah, we even just shared one drink and got some water, so perfect.
Save them pennies, boy.
Got to save those pennies.
Especially on a Disney holiday, bloody hell.
I know. So where to now?
I know, we've got the parade at 3, what time is it now? We've got 45 minutes.
We actually came in because we thought with the party being on tonight it would have been a quieter day. But because it's a Sunday, it's definitely not.
There's also a hurricane coming, so I think everyone's going to the parks now because the parks are probably going to close.
Yeah.
What, 4 days from Tuesday or something like that?
I think, anyway, so we're not sure, but it's a very high crowd day, so we haven't even got in on many rides, but we wanted to do the shows and all that we hadn't done, so that's been achieved.
Yeah.
So we'll see what we get up to now, and maybe go get some photo passes.
Yeah. You get a spot for the parade, but I don't really want to stand out there
in the sun
more than I have to. Okay, we got a spot for the firework. Oh, look at that, just as I said fireworks on. For the parade. So we're just...
So we're just up there for Splash Mountain. Top end of Frontierland. It's also a shady spot under this roof.
So it's incredibly hot today. I know it sounds stupid to say that, but it's very, very warm. So we're going to sit in the shade and then get a good spot. And it also means while the parade goes, we can maybe go over there a bit calmer. Maybe, I don't know.
We're not going very well.
completely forgot to update everybody. We're actually just in the gift shop on the way out, waiting for the parade to go by. See if there's any merch that we've missed, but I feel like we've seen everything now.
We're just holding on for something.
We're holding on for something exciting, but I don't think it's going to happen. Although I do like these.
They're great.
Let's get through then. We're heading out.
Bye bye, Magic Kingdom.
Bye, Magic Kingdom, for this trip.
Miss you forever.
Goodbye.
So now we're going to go to
the Grand Floridian
Resort. Because it's nice.
Oh, I think I have to go this way because the parade's still happening.
The end of the parade's still happening over there.
Yeah, so we're going to go to the Grand Floridian, fill our cups up, and have a look around.
Yeah.
A resort that we'll never ever feasibly ever be able to stay at.
Never know, guys.
Yeah, we might win the lottery, who knows? But yeah, so go away from the castle.
Okay, bye, castle. Bye, castle. Bye, castle. Bye.
That I'm leaving Magic Kingdom.
Wow.
There's nowhere else like it in the world that makes you feel so wonderful.
I think it's more annoying too because we didn't get to do the fireworks yesterday.
Even though
we technically could have, but they made a bit of a boob and where they shepherded everybody and then half of us didn't get to see it. But oh well. So we're about to get on the monorail to go to the Grand Floridian. We've just missed one in classic Nicola and Craig style.
It's alright, they're always like.
Yeah, they don't take too long.
Grand Floridian's over there, but unfortunately we have to go all the way around before we get there.
I mean, there is a walkway. Do you want to walk? Walkway is literally just there. Probably quicker to walk. Well, we can just walk back down this thing again.
Scrap what we just said.
Yeah, scrap what we said. Nicola said, I really want to get on the monorail. And I was like, no, Nicola, let's be healthy. And she was like, no, I want to sit down and do nothing.
Guys,
I was like, no, Nicola, we should walk. No, actually, we kind of agreed we should walk because the walk is new and looks nice. And, oh, look at the doggies in goggles! Oh, cute! Sorry, we get so distracted by dogs.
Can you tell that we miss our dog at home?
Oh, how do you get to the walkway from here? Interesting. Oh yeah, maybe you're right. Okay, maybe it's over here.
We've come out of the park, walked up there, walked back, walked over here. Now we're over here. Oh, that is a dead end. It has to be that way then. Oh my god. Where are we going? No one knows.
Never mind, really. There's a
clearly marked sign that tells us where to go. Okay, if this isn't the right way, the worst thing that can happen is we get a boat instead. So, you know.
Walkway.
So we got a good view of the Grand Floridian when we were on the boats. When we were on the boats about 3 months ago, it feels like.
And then this walkway is relatively new, isn't it? It's only built in the last like 3 years or so, wasn't it?
So handy to have a resort you could walk to the park. That's what Caribbean Beach is.
Yeah, you can't walk to the parks in Caribbean Beach. Well, you technically could, they're that close.
There's just no walkway.
There's just no walkway, but they are close enough where you could walk to Epcot and Hollywood Studios, definitely.
Monorail!
Every time.
What do we do today in the Magic Kingdom?
Shows.
Just some shows, yeah. No rides, boo.
Boo.
I was too busy and I didn't get it. I wasn't for Wine Genie Plus again.
Yeah. So. It's what it is. And we've had lots of time at Magic Kingdom, to be fair.
Yeah.
It was just more that we hadn't done some shows, so that was actually the whole point of today, since that we were last
year. Yeah, and also, like, we could have done a few rides, but I hate waiting for any length of time. So if a ride has like a half an hour wait, I'm like, nah.
People are probably like, wait, you go to Disney World and you hate waiting?
Yeah, but then we do it so we don't have to wait. We're organised. Well, you wouldn't think of it from the last few days, but we are organised.
Oh, the floats for the nighttime show on the lake are down there. The light show, whatever it's called.
Electrical light pageant.
Is that it? Electrical light pageant? Yeah, they have like lighted boats on the water at night. We haven't seen that either. And many things we haven't seen this trip. The staff have pulled the boat in for us already. How lovely.
Waiting on us, guys.
Yeah.
Look at the balconies in the rooms. Like, one day I will stay there and leave.
See if I can zoom in slightly. As close as I can get. But I can't move because it'll be all over the place. But the only thing about staying there is the constant boat noise.
True. So you wouldn't hear it that much.
I suppose, yeah. I suppose you're not allowing me windows open in Florida, are you? then you'd get heat stroke. Heat stroke. Oh, Nick, I get ready to say it. What a whale! We've made it to the Grand Floridian. The only thing our resort is nice. Although the only difference with these deluxe resorts is they're very busy. Not busy like the values are, but there's like, and also, yeah, ours is very homely. This doesn't have that homely vibe. Like, people come to, the lobby here is massive, people come to visit this place. So you don't feel as like cocooned in your own environment here, if that makes sense. So you can actually rent the boats, you can hire those boats here as well. And there's the castle, so you can sort of see where we were in the background. You can do mini golf at this resort, so pretty much that means we have to stay here now. And there's the pool.
The pool isn't as good as ours.
No, we've a better pool. Okay, let's go this way. Oh, always forget there's a spa here. First thing we have to do is find the quick service dining area to get us a drink.
Also, the smell at the Grand Floridian.
Yeah, it smells nice in here always. This is the Grand Floridian. It looks even better from the top floor, but yeah, they have a pianist playing and then sometimes a band plays up in the corner here. One of these corners, I don't know which one. It is very nice. Just give you an idea how big the place is. That's just the main building. It has its own Bibbidi Bobbidi boutique. And then the Michelin, whatever the equivalent of a Michelin star restaurant is here. There's a wedding pavilion, a bridal studio, a whole spa. Has its own villas, a million pools. It's just ridiculous. And monorail and a boat to Magic Kingdom, and you can walk. I mean, actually, that pool's massive. That pool's massive. Well, it only has two pools though.
Yeah, right here, right now.
Hmm? Quick service of Grand Floridian, but look at this thing. This is chocolate. That is chocolate.
I want the
cake. Oh, look at that.
Behind it.
That one looks great.
Look at the black green candle. How much are
you? I just grabbed them yourself.
No, this one was too much, it was. Okay, so we came into their like quick service area and filled up our cups. This is why we find the resort mugs so handy, because you can fill these up in any resorts, but not only that you can fill them up in any resorts, we just fill them up multiple times at our own.
That's the freestyle machines.
Yeah. So we're going to have a little drink here and we're going to see what some of the buns are like, and then we'll get back to you with a little tour around the Grand Floridian. We've got some amazing Hocus Pocus cupcakes. Look at that, it's their hair. So good.
Oh yeah, that's cool.
It's got a tiny white hat, that. Oh, jeez.
But I've got tiny mine.
Try harder than that. Nice. But is it very peanut buttery?
Very little inside.
Oh, good.
It's very moist.
Mm.
No, Max doesn't like it though.
That's why you picked the purple.
Oh, but it's really thick. How thick that is.
Your lips.
Oh no.
Oh no, it was sexy in here. Let's get a little cross section with your big purple. Oh, guys.
You just need a bit of water in the bottom there.
Oh, it's quite soft. Me.
What?
It's like you've got a lipstick
on. No.
You're going to regret all the noise I'm in.
I'm ready for an out of the town, girls.
Okay, so we finished in the quick service of Grand Floridian, and we noticed that there's an arcade, so we're going to go in here and see what the crack is. Or at least I will. Huh? The big reveal. Dun 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 dun.
Oh, there's massage chairs.
Oh, this is awful. This is horrid.
How much are these? $5?
$10 for 25 minutes.
$2 for 5 minutes. I didn't bring my coins.
Oh no. This is actually a terrible arcade. Oh, that's a really cool old school. Old school. Yeah, like the quit the basic.
The Valley Resort.
Valley Resort, so I have great arcades.
We're just sitting in the Grand Floridian lobby. We sat down because we saw a guy at the grand piano, but then he walked off.
And it's so great. We've been here before when they've been playing, and it's so lovely.
He had like a tailcoat on, so we thought, oh, he's going to start. Let's sit down. And then he walked off. So, I don't know if we missed
it. The smell in this lobby.
It smells like, where do you see this?
But we're going to go up on this floor soon, because there's more shops and like
restaurants and stuff. The night we showed you the Animal Kingdom lobby or the Grand Floridian lobby. In my opinion, I like the woodiness of, like, you know, the wood effect of like Animal Kingdom. I haven't showed you Wilderness Lodge, but it comes under my list.
Oh, Wilderness Lodge.
But this is like a very fresh brand, like Victorian.
It looks like colonial America. I don't know. I could be completely wrong about
that. Okay, no one's playing the piano.
No one's playing the piano. Raise him.
Time to go.
This is curious how cold it is. This is all Tommy Bahama stuff. Oh yeah, but then your fits on them half the time, so you don't even see the design. Also, I saw Vine and Vine stuff like after spending there yesterday. Hello.
It's us.
Look, is it not
wild? Oh,
that's good. Oh yeah. It's very it's very, I go off with the lads on a golfing holiday and leave the wives at home.
Oh yes, my wife goes to the Grand Floridian while I play a little bit of golf.
Yeah, just it's emerge is a bit tacky. Imagine wearing that.
Well, there's a beauty in the beach, so I suppose that might
be. Oh, that's actually specific to this resort. It's because it has the Enchanted Rose like bar or whatever it is, isn't it? Right, we go up the stairs then, darling. Hey, did you just trip? What'd you trip on? There's nothing there.
A big step.
Someone's had their drink spiked.
Too much vitamin water, guys.
Mm. Too many vitamins, bad for you. So it was a lounge, Enchanted Rose lounge, Citricos and Victorian Alberts. And the... Wait, there's a basin?
Yeah, that's what I said.
Yeah.
To do this,
well, it's down here. Somewhere we'll go up here first, sure. Yeah, this is the kind of carpet you have in your granny's house, isn't it?
Yeah, my granny still has it.
This is the lounge room. So this is the Enchanted Rose Lounge. It looks very nice. Well, not being drinkers, it would be kind of wasted on us, I think.
Yeah, very.
It's on the way to Victoria and Albert's, where you go to remortgage your house to have dinner. What is it like? Is it a set menu? It's like $300 or something. I'll do it at the top end, yeah. We've got a few more floors, I suppose. Probably a holiday boutique. So go and take your little prince or princess and dress them up.
Dress them up. They get basically a makeover. Yeah.
Oh, basin is here. I thought it's on the ground floor. I think you can get your shop here. This is basically the shop that's in Disney Springs.
Do I have a little nose?
You've seen it in Disney Springs at any point.
Do you want to see the thing here, or yeah, do you want to go up to the top floor?
Well, there's another shop here for you.
Look at, there's 5 floors. Why do you think we're from the top floor?
She's not bad, hey? The dome glass ceilings too, we like it. So Glanfiddin has another gift shop.
Yeah. multiple.
Only has three.
Just while we're here at the gift shop window, you can actually see the kids' splash area and the pool. And then the monorail station that comes right outside. Place is massive.
There's a ton of other stores.
Designer collection dolls. $129.99.
And what are we paying for here?
Probably the box it's in.
But they don't really look like that. I would really expect them to be made from China.
Made from China?
No, made out of China.
Oh, made out of China. Sorry, what? I say, huh? This is made out of chocolate again. Wow. Oh, they're little chocolate drops. Oh my. Oh wow. That's insane.
You also do see Peter Pan and Tinkerbell.
Ugh.
No, Tinkerbell's never
allowed
to
pick
Peter Pan.
Good.
Well,
I hate Tinkerbell.
I'm just walking around to the where they think the spa is. So there's a Polynesian. Actually, probably closer to the Polynesian now, about on the other side of this resort. And there's the wedding chapel. Yeah, you never know. So I was kind of moving when I was doing that, so that might be a bit shaky, but you get the idea. What if you can walk over to it? So this is the bridal studio.
That's where it's coming.
And then this is the wedding chapel. I was hoping the gates would be open so you could at least walk around it, but no, we can't. No guest access. Well, I'll walk up to the sign. Wouldn't be a bad spot, I suppose. I suppose.
The bridal chapel, is it called?
So we've actually walked so far around. So we can actually just walk to the Polynesian Resort from here. So that's what we're going to do.
So we did not have the walkway between the Polynesian and the Grand Floridian, so we ended up walking in this really random, rough bit of land that Disney have just thrown together for the path.
We're also doing up the golf course here, so it's really rough as well.
Minivan, minivan, minivan. Oh, I thought it would stop. Fine. Be that way. Yeah. Boo!
I don't want to go in your minivan anyway.
Yeah. No trespassing. No photography or vehicle unless authorised. Ooh. There's literally nothing to see there. It's just all construction stuff.
So now we're at the Polynesian. I don't know what point we're at. We'll see around the corner, see where it's throwing us out.
So the middle rooms don't have a balcony then?
Unless they're one suite. I don't think I don't know enough about this resort.
Can you hire boats from here? No, I don't see any regular boats you can hire. Because they're the lifeguard boats. I hear I laugh at you. Oh, there's Rihanna's. Up top there. There's probably goes around Grand Floridian as well. Let's have a look. So yeah, it does. Oh no, it doesn't, but you could do that.
It's even less than ours.
Oh, it's tiny.
Oh, well.
But you could just do all that and look around Grand Floridian and then do like about a 3 mile walk. You could do about a 3 mile run then. Do you want to go through the lobby? Or do you want to go around first?
We'll go around first, actually.
I already prefer this than the Grand Floridian, I think. Is there much price difference? I mean, they're both blood expensive, but...
So these are the Mickey tie-dye things you can do.
How cool are they?
Oh, they're cool. You'd always have it then. So there's a marina here. I don't know what boats you can hire, if it works the same as a contemporary, but I don't see any boats that you can hire. But
no,
they must have a marina for a reason.
I don't think Polynesian is listed on it.
No? Oh, there's the boat, so the Magic Kingdom. Like the passenger boat. And then there's the deluxe bungalows. Do they have a slide? Yeah, I think their pool has a slide.
I see steps, but I don't really want to record too much.
the King Camp Mesa Club. I don't know if I've read that properly. I'm just going to see if we can get into one of their internal corridors. I don't think we can. Let's just... Oh, we can. Hello. Oh, yes. It had a magic band thing, so... I don't think I'd actually let us in. This is a big difference between our resort and this. This has internal corridors, like a regular hotel. Very good, very nice. Dining and entertainment. Trader Sam's, Kuna Cafe, Ohana's, which we love.
Pineapple
Island, Boutique, Tambu Lounge, Pineapple and I, and Captain Cook's. Captain Cook's is a quick service place, isn't
it? Do you know what they don't have?
What?
They don't have Cook freestyle machines in their building.
Oh, losers. What losers. So one thing our resort does better is that each resort has these. But our resort has the freestyle machines, not every resort has it. This is a deluxe, and we have better drinks options. And as a quick service dining place goes, this is tiny.
You getting coffee?
Yeah, I think I will actually. That's the Moana cupcake that I wanted to get.
And then that, look at that one.
The Moana one looks amazing. What flavour is it, Joe?
Can't remember.
Oh, we might have to get it.
We'll see. Got a little coffee.
So we're sitting both, despite the heat, we both have a coffee from the Captain Cook's quick service bit in the Polynesian. They're sitting just near their pool having a relax because we have to do something very depressing. And what is that depressing thing? Check into our Virgin Atlantic flight.
The good thing is, guys, I'm getting closer and closer to seeing my Benny.
Yeah. The good thing about this flight is we're still flying economy, but we picked the seats near the front.
Yeah.
No, it's not even exit row, it's the very front, where there's like nothing, it's like nothing in front of us at all. It's like the next way economy split in two. We're the front of the second row, so there's like nothing in front of us. So I can literally like lie on the floor in front of the seat if I wanted. So we might be able for once to actually sleep on the way home.
Possible, but we'll try.
Well, the best version of sleep we could possibly get. I'm being a bad vlogger and forgetting to update what we were doing. So we've just got the monorail from the Polynesian, and we're now getting the bus back to our resort from the Magic Kingdom because it's the easiest way of doing it. So I feel like changing my shoes, because anyway, it doesn't matter how comfortable your shoes are, you feel like you need to change them after being on your feet for a long time. Are we freshen up and then we'll go to Epcot?
Yeah,
for our last night. Maybe eat around some of the food and wine, but we'll just see how we feel. There's literally so much food in the room and we can't take a lot of it home.
Yeah.
Plus we've got about 3 kilograms of candy from the Halloween party 2 weeks ago. Like, we've had that sit in the room all that time, so maybe we'll just eat 25 peanut butter Snickers each for dinner.
Yeah. We'll come in really late at night and I'll be like, well, I can't have any breaks because I've got to sleep.
Yeah.
So then we end up having so much
food. Well, I tend to stuff a sugar cooker in my mouth at like midnight. But where you put your suitcase in the room, we've just put all like, the cereal. Like, we have like 3 boxes of cereal. They're all about half full. But, oh well. We'll just see. Because you can't really, there's no point taking them home. So we'll just see. Okay, we're back at our home resort. We feel tired, just covered your face as you spoke. Filled our cups up.
So yeah, we were just saying that we do prefer our resort, but we think it's just because it holds a special place in our heart for us. It's just the greenery and all. If you know me, you know that I love like woods and foliage and, you know. So yeah, anyway, we're going back to the resort, our room, sorry, with our cups, and we're going to have a little snack and then head out to Epcot. Guys, like, look at this. Just look at this. I don't know if I have more of appreciation because I couldn't get here for a good few years.
Things like this.
Just look at this. Look at this.
This is a wonder, guys.
Me and Craig like to say this is our American home. Isn't it, Craigie?
This is my spiritual home.
When we're having a bad day, we pretend we're here.
Place I'm truly happy.
Okay, guys, we're off to get the Skyliner to Epcot. first we're going to swing by and fill up the water because, you know, we can't drink that Floridian water. We arrived at the Skyliner station. Woo-hoo. So now off to Epcot.
We made it.
We made
it.
Last part.
Probably.
Well, we think we'll go to Disney Springs after this and go to Disney Springs tomorrow. But
yeah, you have to drop the cases off at the
Bell Service.
Bell Services at the resort. And we only have like 2.5 hours then at that point.
Yeah, so
there's nothing, there's no point going into a proper park.
It's not really worth it. So we don't have a long left. See, with these parks closing at 9 since COVID, that's just not not the same. This would be like till midnight.
But anyway, everyone is going to go see Harmonious and then we'll be jumping some rides for the last time.
Yes, and then we'll see the Epcot ball. So that is our plan. Also, guys, because we came out of the at World Showcase because we get the Sky, yeah, International Gateway, because we get the Skyliner, it was so hectic there, so I did show you some of the music and stuff going on there. But now look at the ball, is that not the prettiest thing? I will show you it properly when we get round. Doesn't really come up on camera very well, but it is cool.
We're doing Living with the Land, and it's only me and Nicola.
Relax
and
enjoy living
with the land. So now we're going to do the greenhouses at night.
Yeah.
Last time the greenhouses at night, Christmas, they had all Christmas theming. Do they have Halloween stuff up?
Yeah.
Well, I guess we'll see.
There's the restaurant.
Forces at work on the land, humans have had one of the most profound effects. The need to produce food for a growing world led to the enormous use, and sometimes everyday use, of the land. In our search for more efficient ways to grow food, we often fail to realize the impact of our methods.
In Japan, we're learning that by mixing leaves and other living materials into our soil, we can make farmland more fertile without the need for chemicals. Here at Epcot, we're learning to reduce the need for chemical pesticides by breeding and using natural predators, like ladybugs and wasps, to control pests.
To help us maintain these carefully controlled ecosystems, and for your safety, please remain seated in your boat at all times.
Building that you wondered what it was the other day, is this not it?
Oh, I'm so stupid.
That's what it is.
Next, oh, I was wondering what this building was. Ah, does it look brown?
Yeah.
Oh, silly.
Welcome to our living laboratory, where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring innovative ways to produce bountiful harvests now and into the future. Others are well adapted to growing in less than ideal conditions. Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petals, are edible. The starchy food suffers from water intense. As a result, we're able to save millions of gallons each year. Our world, most of us are only familiar with it. That make up our everyday diet. The common grains growing here,
oh, it's in the Mickey Show.
Maize, sorghum, and millet, plus rice, account for nearly two-thirds of our global food consumption. Learning how to increase yields of these staples is an important goal of research around the world.
Coffee.
Also, coffee.
These plants are definitely on their way up. Innovative growing techniques like these increase yields while more efficiently using resources like water, fertilizer, and pesticides. Greenhouses with beneficial insects that prey on harmful pests like aphids and flies, we are significantly reducing our reliance on conventional pesticides. We're growing these crops using our nutrient film system. This technique precisely controls and recycles water and nutrients. With it, we can produce over 27,000 tons of lettuce a year in this one small area.
Cucumbers on this side.
In fact, we serve more than 15 tons of produce from our greenhouses and restaurants here at the land every year.
More cucumbers.
The future of agriculture may include innovative ideas like this vertical growing system. Plants grown in this way use a fraction of the space required by traditional growing methods. That saves water and increases production. In our lab, Epcot scientists are working with the U.S. Department of Agriculture on a number of innovative projects. The goal of these efforts is to produce higher yielding and better quality plants. Additional growing methods that save water and increases production. The aquaponics system on your left combines hydroponics with
shot of the ball. So nice. This is the last time we'll see it, so just making the most of it.
Nicola, it's the last time we're going to see it for at least, I don't know, 15 months probably. I'm predicting November 2023. Right, we're finally leaving Epcot. I'm actually doing something that we haven't done, and that's leaving out of the actual main exit. Because we're on the Skyliner, we don't actually have to use this one.
It feels very awesome.
But we have to use this one now because we're getting the bus. So I wonder if all this has changed since we last done this. Bye, bye. Be sad. Holiday's nearly over.
Guys, so
hello.
We're
finally
now in
Springs.
Yeah, we didn't film it, but we had such a palaver. So we left Epcot
at the front. That's the last thing you saw was me talking about leaving at the front.
And then we realised we can't get a bus to Disney Springs from Epcot, which
it's
is silly.
It's the only resort that doesn't, the only park that doesn't have a bus to Disney Springs.
So then when
we went to the front for that reason.
Yeah. So then we looked at the bus thing and we're like, what resort is the closest to Epcot? And then we realised, like, oh, none of them, because all the resorts that are closest to Epcot are on the Skyliner, like our resort. So we were like, oh my god, we're at the front of the park. So we then had to go back the whole way through Epcot, back
during the fireworks.
During the fireworks, mad busy, we're running through, I'm sweating, don't have my fan, my hair's everywhere. And then we get through and we decide there's no point going back to our resort, so it was quicker to walk to the boardwalk, get a bus from the boardwalk to Disney Springs.
No, it was no Yacht and Beach.
Yacht and Beach.
We couldn't find the bus.
Yeah, and that was a disaster.
And then the bus took ages, and now we're finally here. So we left Epcot at 8:45,
and now it's
10 o'clock, and we're only here. Disney Springs is only open for another hour and a half.
The world is testing
us.
We haven't even eaten dinner. On our last night, guys. So anyway, we're walking to more and more to Asia to the... Do you know the bit?
The to-go window
that we were telling you about the other night, but we didn't end up going. So we're going to see if we can go there and just get like a poke bowl or something like that. But yes, we will update you with the latest when we're there.
The Disney gods hate us. Because the more and more Asia street food thing
is closed.
Bye!
I just want dinner. It's our last full day. All I want is dinner, and I can't get dinner because everything's took so long.
Do you know what? We should have gone back to the resort and had dinner.
Yeah, we should have. Can't even go back to the resort and get dinner now because the restaurant closes at 10. So, well, you might get back there in time, but... Oh, yeah, it's 10 now. I forgot. Oh, I'm so hungry to think.
Oh, my God. Earl of Sandwich is a shout. Earl of Sandwich? Okay, cool. Earl of Sandwich then.
Also, the other problem we've had is we've had to walk from one end to the other of every place we've been. We walked one end to the other of Epcot and back. We've walked one end to the colour of the Yacht and Beach Club and then halfway back to find the bus. We've now looped Disney Springs and now we're walking away to the other end again. Because the other sandwiches, of course, is at the very one of the last units at the old part of the area. I see it. Well, we see it. We see it in the distance. It's like, buy my sandwiches. Nicola also informed me that we have a... Disney used to give you a... Well, you got a voucher book thing, and then you got like a blue card, and you carried it with you. And they'd scan the card and you get discounts, but you don't get the card anymore. You just have this voucher like sheet that you print out, and you get 10% off here. But guess where the voucher sheet is? In the room. Oh, we made it. And it looks open. Oh, I've never been so excited to get a sandwich in my life.
It's 10:05 though. Oh, it's really cheap. So we got a sandwich, potato tots on the side, and a drink for $14.36.
We just got one because last time when we were actually in here, there was a lot of sandwich. And it's very late, guys.
And also, it's really late. We're really hungry, but at the same time, it's not so late we're eating.
Yeah.
How overtly British is this cup?
So we got our tater tots.
Holy sandwich. It's just smaller than it was last time. No, I think they look bigger when we open them. Sandwich looks great. The lighting isn't the best, but let's see inside. I mean, they're pretty packed. The lighting is bad. Oh no. I mean, that's pretty. I mean, that's not a sandwich as we know it, but it's good. It's good. We had our little Earl of Sandwich guy. Hi.
So it was good. It's just kind of like a Subway type style thing. Maybe
it was better than Subway.
Better fillings.
To be honest, I think I could have eaten like a cup of sand and been like,
he was so hungry. But anyway, we just shared it because it was enough for this time of night, wasn't it really?
Yeah. Today has been a bit of a disaster.
It really has, our last day.
Well, not a disaster, but like just, I don't know.
It seems like we were just constantly having to rush everywhere, but we didn't get anything done. Says I think we should have planned just to stay at the resort today, but anyway, look, it is what it is, and I says to Greg, we could have a disaster of a day at home, and that would be way worse than a disaster running around at Disney. Yeah, I'm going to too. Okay, so we're now going to think we're just going to make our way out, because by all the time we've done all this, it's nearly 20 to 11. Disney Springs closes at 11. So we're going to go back, get our resort mugs, and do a little bit of packing, and then finish the vlog, guys. Hi, guys.
Hello.
Sorry, hold on till I get forensic files off, because that's my favourite thing here. Sorry, you can get forensic files at home, but it's just shown all the time here. Anyway, you're probably thinking, Nick, what happened to your face? I just came in, forgot where to end the vlog, took my makeup off, and quick took all his clothes off. So I've got...
Well, not all my clothes.
Craig's got a naked body behind me. I'm joking. Anyway, guys, so... We went, got the bus, and my night was made because I think I told you we had the loveliest bus driver the other night called Deirdre, and we actually put in a little compliment about her, a little like thing just to say how she'd gone out of her way to take us home. And it was her tonight again, and she went out of her way to take us
home. The chances of getting the same person is like slim.
It's very slim, and she says she never actually does this route. So she went out of her way to make sure we got home, and she actually told us she had actually received her cast compliment. So it's something that you can just do in the app, and that she says it's something that actually goes on their record, and she really, really appreciated it. And I always say that the cast members make Disney for you. Like, she didn't have to go out of her way, and just, isn't she the sweetest human?
Yeah, because we missed the Caribbean Beach bus, so you can get the Riviera bus, which is the resort next to us, so we were going to walk, and then she asked where we were going, and then I was like, oh wait, you did this for us last time. Yeah.
She's just honestly such a lovely human. So just always remember it's the cast members who make it here, and if they've gone out of their way just to, not even gone out of their way, but if they've just done something that's made your day a little bit easier, a little bit brighter, just put a wee thing in for them, because I think it really makes a difference to them. And you know, you sort of take them for granted here because there's so many of them and they all do such an amazing job, but yeah, it probably makes a difference to them too to know that, you know, you've made it, like they've made a difference in your night. So yeah, she was really tickled by that. So we're in the room and we're now just gonna get ready for bed and do a little bit of packing, nothing too exciting. So we're just gonna end the vlog now. Sorry if today was a bit all over the place. I feel I've said that about the last couple of days, well, last couple of weeks for you guys, but yeah, it was just one of those days. It was like, we went to the park, it was so busy, blah, blah, blah. You've watched the footage.
Yeah, disaster.
But anyway, look, whatever. But look, as I said to you before, I'd rather be having a random day in Disney World than a random day at home. So, you know, just
that's
count our blessings that we're even here. So, Craigie, highlight of today?
Oh, Deirdre, to be fair.
Oh, see, I tell you.
Yeah.
Same for me. This, the way the cast members can go out of their way, I'm going to stop heart rolling because I just be like, she's just a wonderful human, and she really was. So yeah, with that.
I'm half asleep. Also, I enjoyed doing Carousel Of Progress.
Oh, you haven't actually done that.
Very iconic.
True.
That wee song gets stuck in your head too.
But yeah, and I think also beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day.
Anyway.
But also I think just a highlight for me today was just like realizing, like, as it comes to the end of the trip, that it's really sad, and yes, it's like sad that it's over, but I'm honestly just so grateful to have even experienced this trip with the chaos of COVID and trips being moved and the cost of living and everything else. I just feel so incredibly lucky to be here, and it was like one of those moments where I'm like, frick, I got to have this trip, you know?
Yeah.
So yeah, just very grateful, guys.
Yeah.
But yeah, guys, so with that being said, we are going to sign off for tonight. So if you enjoyed the video, please give it a big thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it if you could come subscribe to my little YouTube family. And yeah, tomorrow's video, we are going to head to Disney Springs, we think, we hope, get breakfast and all that fun stuff. And then it is the sad travel home, which we will bring you along for.
We're only going to Disney Springs for a couple of hours. That's all we have. It's just to get a few gift things we need to grab.
Yeah, and then we will do the whole journey home with you from Orlando to London. Then we're in London for a total of like 16 hours, doing absolutely nothing.
Our flight kept getting cancelled. So we had a flight for midday at Heathrow. It got cancelled 3 times, and now it's at like 7:30. And we get into Heathrow at 6:30 in the morning. So we have 13 hours in Heathrow.
We will try and probably go to the lounge, lounge or something, but we obviously can't do that till we can like,
we have to wait to check into the flight.
Yeah, so
we've got 10 hours to kill before we even go to the lounge.
So it's going to be a long day, but we'll bring you along. Obviously, we won't show you all that because it'll be so heck of a boring vlog. But anyway, so we will bring you along in that, and then we will probably let you see us being reunited with Benny. That is the one thing that I'm like buzzing to get home about, to see my wonderful little Benny. But yeah, guys, gonna love you and leave yous now.
Oh,
that's my watch telling me that it's better.
Watch is telling you to go to bed.
I appreciate you all so much. Thank you if you've subscribed by now. Love you all. Sending positive vibes to each and every one of you and a little bit of Disney magic. But I'll catch you in the next one. Night night.
Bye.